Let's get an update on the weather now with PAGASA forecaster Benison Estereja. Hi, Benison.
Hello, Ms. Katrina, and all our viewers. As of 3 in the morning, the low pressure area was estimated over the coastal waters of Caramoran, Catanduanes, and this low pressure area has a slim chance of becoming a tropical depression, and in fact, it may dissipate within the next 24 hours. On the other hand, the shear line is affecting the eastern sections of northern and central Luzon, whereas the northeast monsoon Ramihan continues to affect the rest of northern and central Luzon. For today, expect some cloudy skies with scattered rain showers and thunderstorms over Metro Manila, as well as mainland Cagayan, Isabela, Aurora, Bulacan, Calabarzon, Marinduque, and Camarines Norte due to both the LPA and shear line, whereas for Cordillera region, Nueva Ecija, and the rest of Cagayan Valley, expect some light to moderate rains due to Amihan. Ilocos region and the rest of central Luzon will have partly cloudy skies and at times cloudy skies with isolated light rains due to Amihan as well, whereas the rest of the country will have some localized thunderstorms mostly in the afternoon or evening. And that's the latest from PAGASA Weather Forecasting Center. This is Benison Estereja.
Thank you for making time for us this morning, PAGASA forecaster Benison Estereja. Millions of Filipinos flocked to cemeteries to mark All Saints Day. Around 100,000 passengers flew from Manila's main gateway Tuesday. About the same number of passengers boarded buses in the Parañaque Integrated Terminal Exchange as they head to the provinces for the holiday. Meanwhile, in some of the biggest cemeteries in the metro, hundreds of thousands are expected to visit today. Police presence has also been ramped up to help secure the holiday.
Ako'y masaya dahil the city government of Manila together with the national agencies of government, no, from the PNP to the BG, to the fire, etc., and of course the NGOs, lahat nagkatulungan.
The full alert will be in effect until suspended. Siguro aabot yan pagkatapos ng undas kasi nandiyan na. Dire-direcho yan yung ating election. It's not yet over because meron pa tayong reverse na gagawin. Yung mga paraphernalia, election returns, kailangan nating ma-preserve such that mapupunta yan sa COMELEC at saka sa treasurer's office ng kada munisipyo.
After two straight months of acceleration, the Philippine Central Bank expects inflation to ease slightly in October. The Consumer Price Index is seen to settle within the range of 5.1 to 5.9% on the back of lower oil prices and key agriculture commodities. Meanwhile, the uptick in electricity prices and transportation costs may have contributed to the upward pressure for the month. Philippine inflation accelerated for a second month in September to 6.1%. The BSP delivered an off-cycle rate hike last week in a bid to help tame stubborn inflation. Now, the Philippine government's outstanding debt dips in September to 14.27 trillion pesos. That amount is 80 billion pesos lower compared to August, primarily due to net repayments of both domestic and external obligations. The Treasury Bureau says debt payments surged by 57% from January to September. Now, the nine-month debt payments amounted to 1.4 billion pesos. That's significantly higher than the nearly 890 billion posted last year. Meanwhile, Philippine officials refute China's allegations that a Philippine Navy ship illegally entered its waters. Bianca Dava reports.
The Philippines asserted on Tuesday it has every right to patrol the West Philippine Sea, including Scarborough Shoal or Bajo de Masinloc, which is well within the country's 200 nautical mile exclusive economic zone. In a statement, National Security Advisor Eduardo Anyo countered the Chinese military's claims that a Philippine Navy vessel illegally entered an area near Scarborough Shoal under China's sovereignty. According to the Armed Forces of the Philippines, BRP Conrado Yap was conducting sovereignty patrols near Bajo de Masinloc on Monday when it spotted a vessel from the People's Liberation Army Navy some 2.7 nautical miles away. The AFP denied that the Philippine warships' movement was restricted by China.
There was no restriction because how can they restrict us in our own area, in our own maritime zone? We cannot trespass in our own backyard and no one can prevent us from entering our own home. So there is no truth to what they're saying.
China's military on Monday accused the Philippine warship of trespassing into waters near Scarborough Shoal, which Beijing calls Huangyan Dao, prompting the Chinese People's Liberation Army Southern Theater Command to track, monitor, warn, and restrict BRP Conrado Yap's movement. But the NSA said there was no untoward incident during the patrol operations. Anyo added China is overhyping the incident, creating unnecessary tensions between Manila and Beijing. For the AFP, meanwhile, China's narrative is not intended for the Philippines, but for its own people.
I don't think it is directed to us. Probably they just want to show off. The UNCLOS is very clear. The arbitral award is very clear. They are not supposed to interfere with our legitimate operations.
The Philippines urged China anew to respect the UNCLOS, adhere to the 2016 arbitral ruling, and stop its aggressive and illegal actions in the West Philippine Sea. Meanwhile, Philippine Coast Guard spokesperson for the West Philippine Sea Commodore J. Tarjala disputed three pro-China narratives being spread by some groups to divert attention from Beijing's aggression. Tarjala dismissed claims that speaking up against China's aggression in the West Philippine Sea will lead the Philippines into war. Tarjala explained, keeping the public aware of China's violations of international law safeguards the country from political manipulation and disinformation. Another argument rejected by Tarjala is that the Philippines' efforts for transparency are solely influenced by the United States. Tarjala, however, pointed out such actions are driven by the country's national interest and protection of maritime rights. The PCG official also said pro-China individuals are accusing those who are critical of China as being anti-Filipino and pro-US. Tarjala, however, countered, individuals who are critical of Beijing's actions are driven by their dedication to the Philippines. The National Security Council earlier said it is monitoring influencers and groups who parrot China's sentiments on the West Philippine Sea. Bianca Dava, ABS-CBN News.
Japanese Prime Minister Fumio Kishida making a two-day official visit to the Philippines this week. Kishida will arrive Friday, November 3rd. He will hold talks with President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. on a range of issues, including security and economic cooperation. Marcos visited Japan in February, during which he received $13 billion in investment pledges.